Kiss me.
Hi, I'm Paula, and I'm going to be showing you Katy Perry look number 2. It's going to be the victory rolls, the ones that she has when she's dancing. So I'm going to be showing you how to do that, and I'm also going to be showing you the way that I like to do my victory rolls, which is this. I hope you guys enjoy it. So let's get started. Okay, first we're going to do Katy Perry's victory rolls, which are way bigger than mine. And they're slightly a bit different, so you guys can decide which one you guys like to do better and just whatever goes well with your hair. So first off, you're going to start by parting your hair right down the middle. Katy Perry, in the video, she actually, I think, moosed up her hair or probably put, like, some Layrite or, maybe pomade to hold up her bangs, because she does have bangs earlier in the video. But, you know, if you guys wanted to try that look without the bangs, then you guys can use some mousse or hairspray or just hair gel or whatever works for you guys. But I'm going to be keeping my bangs on, so let's get started. You're going to go from your ear all the way up, slide your finger all the way up to the middle of where the hair is parted. And it's going to look kind of like this. It's going to look kind of like a triangle. And you're going to grab a regular comb and just go from up, I mean down to the top. And you're going to stick your index finger right in here and just wrap your hair right around that index finger. And then you're going to take your index finger out, but your other hand is still going to be holding a curl. You can stick your fingers in there and just, if you want to make the circle more defined, you just grab a bobby pin. And you can. And if you have a lot of hair like me, you're going to need 2. So one in the front and one in the back. Just to hold it tight so then it doesn't get up loosey. You might need 3. Okay. So that's how it is. And you're going to do the same thing on the other side. You're going to grab the comb and comb up. Like little baby hairs. Okay, then you're going to stick your finger, curl around your finger. If you want to use 2 fingers to make it more defined, don't bother me. Okay. If you want to stick your fingers, 2 fingers instead of just 1 to make the circles more defined, you can do that. That way it's easier for you to let the hair loose. And I'm going to do 1 in the back. Okay. And if you guys don't like that it sticks out too much, you guys can always grab more pins, hold it down, and put more pins in there. It's all up to you guys to make it up to how big you want it or how small you want it. Or it's all up to you guys. I'm going to make mine a little bit bigger. Okay. So that's pretty much how she has her hair. She's dancing like this. And she has a little flower in her hair, a little bow in her hair. This little flower piece is from Zombie Girl Accessories, and she has a MySpace that I'm going to post. I don't know if it's this way, that way, but I'm going to post the link on the side. She has so many bows that you guys can look at. She is really, really good. She has so many cute bows. She has bows, she has flowers, she has all this stuff that you guys can look at. And they're all, I think, $4 each, so it's a really, really good price. And she sends them to you in the cutest package. She sends them to you in little popcorn bags with this little Zombie Girl Accessories little card clipped on it. So it's a lot of fun, and she has really, really cute clips. So I'm going to be using this one today. And you can just pin it on the side. I'm left-handed, so the clip is on the wrong side, but... So, that's really cute. And then now I'm going to be showing you how to do it my way. I like to do my victory rolls a little bit different than the way that Katy Perry has them. So you're just going to let it down. And you're going to be using the same technique, the triangle thing, where you scoop up the hair from your ear to the top of your head. But it's going to be a smaller triangle, so you're going to go slightly more up. So instead of going up here all the way up, you're going to just go more slanted. And then before, I put my index finger right here. We're going to put my index finger right here. And we're going to curl. We're still going to curl the hair around it. And you're still going to take your finger out. And you're going to kind of place it on top of your head and then push a little bit out. You can just play with it. Okay. And you're just going to pull that. Okay. I have really, really thick hair, so. I need like a lot of clips. I actually found this door around my house that has long bobby pins. So that way it covers more of my hair. I know the ones they have at Target and Walmart. I don't like Walmart bobby pins for some reason. Or they have long ones too at Sally's. But they're probably a bit expensive. But I'm sure you guys can find a place where they have long bobby pins. They hold really, really good too. Okay. So that's the way that I like to do mine. Because I don't like it to be so out and up there. So I like to just keep it to the side. I don't like the huge big ones. They look good on other girls, but not on me. So if you drop something on the floor, you can be like, "Where did I drop something?" Bend down, and they'll be like, "Oh, that's so cute." That's how it'll turn out to look. The other ones are more, you know, you can tell more that they're like jewels. But this is the way that I like to do mine. So whichever way that you guys like to do it. And please go take a look at Zombie Girl Accessories. She has really cute hair clips. And they're really inexpensive. So they go with any look. Alright, thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'm going to keep you updated because I'm going to be doing look number 3 really, really soon. And that's going to be the funeral one. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Comment and subscribe. Thank you. Easily done once you